Prime Minister Robin Anabanja says the ban on timber export takes immediate effect. She instructed all government law enforcement agencies to implement the directive.
With effect from 29th, we are stopping the degradation of forests as per the presidential directive. That is, we are stopping the issuance of licenses, and impact assessment licenses or permits to all our investors who have been harvesting the forest products across the country.
We have committed ourselves to implement the presidential directive up to the dot. And therefore, I call upon my technical team, the whole country. I'm happy I have the ED NEMA acting. We have the ED NFA. We have the technical team who are here, who have attended this meeting. And we are going to swing in action. We are going to go out into the field and check, front check on these various small companies who have gotten our license, telling us they are going to add value to our forest products, but at the end, they don't add value and they're exporting.
Lands Minister Judith Nabakova says they have begun to investigate land titles issued in government forest reserves.
We have started a process of looking at the titles that were created in the Central Forest Reserves, but also other protected areas. We are going to be more than ready to support the team by initiating the cancellation of those titles.
Dr. Edward Mukiza, the Director General of Uganda Investment Authority, notes that Uganda is a biodiversity country and that forest cover should be protected from even investors.
Uganda is the fifth most biodiverse country. It means if you're coming to invest in biodiversity, Uganda is the place to be. So I applaud this initiative by you, right over Prime Minister, to implement the presidential directive to continue making Uganda an investment destination for biodiversity.
Prime Minister Robin Anabanja says the government has put in place a legal team to address any issues that may arise as a result of the directive.
The committee of the Air Policy Committee for Environment, era nabo babadde mu kuteesa kuno ne tulabira ddala nga kyetaagisa okulaba ng'obutonde bwaffe tubukuuma.
In a related development, the National Policy Committee on Environment also resolved to suspend all activities taking place in Bugoma Forest. Nabakova says the Bugoma Central Forest Reserve Boundary Opening Report is ready and will be availed to the public next week.
By next week, I'll be submitting the report to the different entities and we will take up from
there. According to available data, Uganda had 10 million hectares of forest cover, which fell to 4.9 million hectares by 1990. Currently, forest cover is at 2 million hectares. According to Volza's Uganda export data as of May 2023, timber export shipments from Uganda stood at 2,500, exported by 154 Uganda exporters to 269 buyers. Uganda exports most of its timber to Kenya, India, and Vietnam. Report by Ismail Kasoha for the news.